What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over how to configure the Multiverse plugin for your Apex Minecraft server. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. Multiverse this, Multiverse that. When is Doug going to finally be on screen with the other versions of himself? I mean, Rust Doug versus Valheim Doug? Anyways, at the very least, we can get started with Multiverse-core, a plugin that directly aims to fix this problem by allowing multiple worlds to be created and accessed on a single server. Whether you have creative and survival worlds, minigames, or more, Multiverse can provide it all. Installing and starting Multiverse Core can be pretty confusing for unfamiliar players, so that's why we made this tutorial to walk you through every step of the way. We are, of course, going to start off by downloading the Multiverse Core plugin. Hop on their Multiverse Bucket page, which of course will be linked in the description of this video, and then click on the File button near the top of the page. You could sort by version and date that it's uploaded by. Make sure that whatever version you pick for your server, ours is going to be a 1.16.5, so we're going to make sure that we get a 1.16 version. And we're going to make sure that we get the most updated version or the most recent version for this plugin. Now that you've found the most updated version for your server, go ahead and click on the download button. Once it's downloaded, move it to a folder you can easily locate it later on to upload to your server. Installing on your server is also super easy. All you're going to need to do is navigate to your Apex server panel and then click on stop. You want your server to go from online to offline. And once it's offline, make sure that you scroll down to the game file section. Just make sure that your server is running a plugin compatible version, such as Paper Minecraft. Now that you're sure you're running a compatible version of Paper Minecraft, go ahead and click on FTP file access on the left-hand side of the panel and log in with your information, and then find the plugins folder and click into it. Now click on upload in the top left. Now open up the folder where you downloaded your file to earlier and just click and drag it to the right-hand side of the page. Now just wait for it to fully upload 100% and 1 out of 1 files. And once that's done, click on the name of your server at the top of the page. And from here, either start or restart your server to load up any changes. Now we're going to show you how to get started and specifically how to generate a new world. With Multiverse Core, generating an extra Minecraft world is as easy as entering a command into the console. If you've never opted yourself, don't forget to type op username in console before you initiate this. In game, some commands are going to want to use the /mv space create and then space world name and then a world type format. For example, let's go ahead and type in /mv space create space the name of a world space normal. Now when I hit enter, this is going to make a random overworld. Like, It really could be any just regular survival world seed. On the other hand, if I wanted to get a little wacky and a little wild, also at the same time, I could type in /mv create space Doug arcade space normal space -t space and in all caps flat. And when you hit enter, this is going to make a super flat overworld, which of course you might get killed by slimes in. That's just part of having a server. Then you can also type in /mv create space the name of a world space nether. And this is going to make a nether world. The next command is /mv space create space world name space end. And this is going to, of course, make an end world. Alternatively, if you want to use the worlds that you uploaded earlier, it's pretty simple to do. This can be beneficial for uploading your favorite worlds or including possible minigames. For detailed instructions on how to upload a world through the FTP, find a world on your computer, or even just export a world, visit our knowledge base. But just for today, just for this example, for vanilla Java Minecraft, just go ahead and open Minecraft. And once Minecraft is open up, go ahead and click on installations. Then click on the little folder, and this is going to open up your Minecraft saves. Find the saves folder and click into it. Now, simply find the world that you'd like to upload to your server. I'm just going to click and drag this somewhere I can easily find later on, here along with all of my other world folders. Now, all we need to do is make sure that the world name is something you can easily copy. But ultimately, all of these files or any files you upload should probably be zipped up. Using a program like 7-Zip, make the world you're using compressed and into a zip file by right-clicking, hovering over 7-Zip, and then adding to the name of the folder, .zip. This makes the file smaller for easier upload. Be careful to zip the file up, and once all of your files are zipped up, you are ready to upload them to your server. Of course, we're going to start off by making sure that our server is offline once we're on our panel. If your server isn't offline, be sure to absolutely nuke that stop button. And once it's offline, click on FTP file access to the left-hand side of the page. Log in with your information and just stay in the root folder. Then click on upload to the top left of the page. Now, open up the folder with all of your zipped worlds and click and drag them one by one. We recommend dragging them one by one so it's easier to upload them to your server. If you find trouble or you find that some of them are just taking ages to load, we have tons of guides on how to use FTP file access programs instead. It'll be more reliable and a lot quicker. Regardless, once you do have all of your files uploaded, click on back and navigate to FTP file access to check the box next to all of your world folders. Then click on unzip at the top to unzip your world. Now click on submit and wait for one done return message for every file that you uploaded. Here, we uploaded three files, so we got three done returned okay messages. Then click on the name of your server at the top of the page and either start or restart your server to get it up and running. Again, before you hop in game, be sure to hop into console and type OP and your username to use commands in game. Once you are sure that you're off, in game use the following command, /mv space import space the name of your world, case sensitive of course, space, and then type. Both the name and the world type will need to match the one that is being uploaded. For example, if you're uploading an end world, make sure that you add the end to the end of it. And if you're uploading just a normal survival world or an adventure world, make sure that you're using normal. Of course, the command format is /mv space import space name of the world space world type. And now we're going to go over some notable commands. /mv space set space spawn sets the respawn point for a world. /mv space tp space username of player space world name will teleport a player into a different world. /mv space unload space world name unloads a world from the server. And /mv space load space world name enables an unloaded world. The last command we're going to go over is /mv space game rule space rule space value, so true or false, space world name is going to set a game rule for a specific world. So if you want to turn keep inventory on, this is the command you need to use. Consider visiting the multi-core command page for more information on commands and their usage. And with that, you should know how to install and navigate the basics of the Multiverse-core plugin. With the ability to add and customize each world directly, there's no limit to what can be achieved. You gather your worlds and prepare to embark across a multi-world journey. Well, folks, we hope you liked this tutorial, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.